Hello viewers, in my previous lectures I have already talked about Lakshmi and Saraswati, the consorts of Vishnu, in various forms in arts and their forms, how they are shown in ancient Indian texts. Today I will talk about Parvati, the consort of Shiva in central and Northern Indian art. Parvati is the form of the goddess most closely related to Shiva. According to Hindu scriptures, Parvati took birth at the behest of Brahma for the very purpose of alluring Shiva into marriage and having his child. These accounts indicate that she had a previous incarnation as Sati, who had also been Shiva's consort. In that life, she immolated herself after hearing her husband insult, thus lending her name to the infamous rite of Sati. Parvati is the ideal chaste wife and devotee of Shiva Mahadeva. There are many Puranic and Tantric texts in which detailed spiritual instructions are given in the form of conversation between two, like her ascetic husband, who is often called as the perfect yogi. Parvati is given two spiritual practices and austerities, Lord drawing him into household life and becoming the mother of his two sons, Ganesh and Sakanda. She is shown by many names such as Giraja and Hemavati, which indicates her role as the daughter of the Himalaya mountains, Kameshwari, the controller of the god of desire and Uma. Other names related to her identity as Shiva's consort include Ishani, Bhivani, Maheshwari and Yogeshwari. The Kurma Purana lists 108 epithets of Parvati. The artists of the ancient India visualized the images of Parvati with various iconographic traits. Most of these images are based on the textual references. Parvati remained quite popular in all the periods. The texts like the Dipanava, Diva Murti Prakarna, Rupamandala, etc., and other Shilpa texts mentions about the images of Parvati. A number of 12 gaudis has been narrated in the ancient Sanskrit texts like Aparajita Pricha. Rupamandala gives names of 6 gaudis: Uma, Parvati, Sirya, Rambha, Chothela, Tripura. The Agni Purana, Chaturbhunga Chintamani, explains the forms of Gauri. The Devi Mahatmya refers to different Shaktis which were caused to be originated from Parvati's body. The same text describes that she was born as the daughter of the mountain Himavat. Hence, she was called Parvati. The Rupamandana and the Aparajita Pricha, two states four-handed Parvati. Kumara Sambhava of Kalidas explains the meanings of her names. For example, Parvati, Uma and Aparna. Gopinath Rao discusses the images of Parvati with four hands, carrying the Akshmala, Shiva and Ganesha and Kamandalu with hands and resting between two fire pots. The images of Parvati in the early Shunga, Kushan, Gupta, Pratiharas, Chindhelas and Chalukyans and numerous other dynasties are quite significant and meaningful. The figures of Parvati were sculptured in the Kushan period in the region of Mathura. She is represented as performing penance to win Shiva in marriage. She stands in the Samabhanga pose between two flames, symbolizing Panch Tapana. She wears Jatabhara and holds a Shakti in the right hand, while the left is held in Katyabalambita pose. Another image of Parvati from Mathura, now in Mathura Museum, represents the four-armed Parvati on one leg, performing tapas in the midst of four sitters. A bearded man, probably Agni, is also shown. She touches the Shivalinga and Ganesh with her hands. She is accompanied by two female figures seated on lotus. Thus, images go to the early medieval period. The medieval image from Gopeshwar is also interesting. The goddess performs penance. Parvati is seated in Swarta Asana and has Jatabhara which are falling on her shoulders. No ornament appears on her body. A yoga pata passes around her body and legs. She is in meditation. She is four-armed holding lotuses in the back, two hands, and the front two are resting on the lap. Sathanaka images of Parvati became popular in the post-Gupta period. Such images are either standing on a seat or on a godha, whereas the asana murtis are shown as seated on nandi, lotus or on a throne. An interesting image of Parvati of the Gupta period has been found from Tomin, Madhya Pradesh. Here she is on the vahana, simha with a child seated on her thigh, sheltering under a tree. Another child is shown standing to her right, slightly below the figure of Devi. A significant image of Parvati from Bhatara, Satna, is carved on a stele of sandstone. She wears the Jatamukta and the Uttariya flows upon her body. It has beautiful features with pointed nose and long ear lobes. It may be placed to circa 6th century AD. One standing image of Parvati with four hands was recovered from Modi, Mandasar. It may be dated circa 8th century AD. It is carved on the sandstone. Apart from these, in the temples of early medieval period of central India, datable to circa 8th to 9th century AD of the Pratihara period, the images of Parvati in Panchatapas remain in frequent occurrence. In the temples of Bhateshwara, Morina, Amrol in Gwalior, Mahua and Terai Badoho Pathari, means Videsha, Indore in Guna. Such images of Parvati are found in abundance here. Parvati, Panchatapas found from Dhammo, datable to circa 9th century AD, carved on red sandstone. She has four hands carrying a yudhas in her hands. She is adorned with Jatamukta, Satanahara, embroidered sari, and Kati Mekhala. Her vahana is shown in the pithas. An image from Yogeshwara represents the Sthanaka Murti of Parvati in Samabhanga pose, wearing sari extra. She is adorned with beautiful combed hair. She is four-armed, holding lotuses in the back two hands, peculiar kamandalu with spout in the front left, and a rosary in the front right hand raised in the Abhaya Mudra. Her sari with crisp vijay are shown on the right and left. The image may be placed in the 9th or 10th century AD. Another image from the same location represents Parvati similarly executed, carrying a lotus flower in the back right, a rosary in the front right, an Agni Punja, means flame, in the back left, and a Kamandalu in the front left hands. It goes to 9th and 10th century AD. The image of Parvati from Vajranath temple in Almora is profusely carved. She is standing in Samabhanga pose, adorned with Jatamukta, Sarpakundala in the right ear, and an ordinary kundalas in the left. She wears hard vanamala, Kati Sutra, Kayura with Kirti Mukha designs, Kankana, Anga, and embroidered drapery. She possesses four arms carrying Kamandalu, a rosary, and a shrak, while the front right hand is held in Varada Mudra. This sculpture is beautifully carved with the figures of several gods and goddesses, such as Lakshmi seated on a lotus, Jaya, Vijaya, Brahma, Agni, Shiva on Nandi, Ganesh, Bhuta, Ganas, Vidyadharas, and Ganga with extraordinary beauty of 9th and 10th century AD. The image tallies with canons in carrying a rosary, Kamandalu, and a lotus. The goddess Parvati in Dvibhanga pose stands on a pedestal under which a lotus creeper with winding items are quite prominent. Her lower right hand is in Varada Mudra. She carries a Trishul with the upper right hand. She wears the jatamukta, embossed with an oval lata tikka. She is adorned with round kundala, ikkavali, kayura, valyas, kati mekhala, and long vajanti mala. A female stands cross-legged. She holds a water vessel. The exterior on the left is decorated with a crocodile. Above it, Goddess Saraswati is shown holding stalked lotus in her right hand. A seated female figure holding the chori is also depicted. She wears usual ornaments. Her hair is combed in curls and a big one is shown on the back. The Vahana Simha is shown on the left. It was brought from Ashapuri and may be placed to 10th century AD. A medieval sculpture from Jogeshwar shows the goddess Parvati standing on a godha in Samabhanga pose. She wears her usual ornaments. The image agrees with the text in having a rosary and a kamandalu with Varta Mudra. Asana Murti of Parvati is shown with four arms. She is seated in Lalita Asana on a pedestal. She carries a trident and a Matulinga fruit in the two right hands, a noose in one of her left hands, and the fourth one holding a child in her lap. It is in the collection of Bharat Kala Bhavan Banaras. Asana Murti of Parvati is beautifully carved in the wall of Vaidyanath temple. She carries a fruit and a khetaka in the front and left hands. She is seated on a pedestal. An image from Gopeshwar represents the figures of Parvati seated on a lotus, wearing a deer skin and her usual ornaments. She has two arms holding a kamandalu in the left hand and the right hand is held in the abhaya pose. One more example of Asana Murti is from Sanghaleshwar, Chamoli. Here Parvati is seated on Nandi in Lalita Asana. She is shown with four arms, carrying a fruit in the front left, Shakti in the back left, snake in the back right, while the front right hand is in Abhaya Mudra. One interesting image from Jogeshwar represents Parvati simultaneously seated on Nandi and a lion together. She carries a trident and a snake in one side and a bell, a fruit in the other side. Asana Murti over a Shivalinga is also significant. It is in the collection of Bharat Kala Bhavan Varanasi. She is shown seated on a Shivalinga in a Lalit Asana. The Linga has a Brahma Sutra at the top. This sculpture may be assigned to circa 9th, 10th century AD. Some of the images of Parvati of 10th century AD have been brought to notice from Bhopal, Sahdol, Damo, Ashapuri, Mandasar, extra of the Madhya Pradesh, which are preserved in the museums. Numerous images of Parvati belong to the Paramara period of 11th century AD. One image of Parvati stands on lotus feet, resting on the back of an alligator as notable piece. The goddess is heavily adorned with ornaments. The head is carved with a jatahara and the background of a pratyamandala carved with a single hand of lotus petals. The lower part is covered with a lower garment suspended from her waist. The upper portion is bare. She is attended by Annapurna on one side. There are numerous figures around in various actions. Just above the attendants are four burning fires in pots, Agnikundas. On the upper, Shiva and Ganesha have respective places. At the top, two-handed Kartikeya is seated with a spear in his right hand and cock in the left. The torso of Parvati from Riva is in Ardha Priyanka Asana. Two lions are carrying the pitha and the deity has eight heads. The Gandharvas and attendants are related to the main theme. It may be assigned to 11th century AD. The excellent image of Parvati of the Kalachuri period, recovered from Sirpur excavation. She holds in her four hands Kalash, Akshmala, Shivalinga and Ganesh in her hands. One image of Parvati from Chandhila period of 12th century is highly ornamented. She carries Ganesh and Kartikeya in her arms. On the upper side, Brahma and Vishnu and the Vidyadharas are shown sitting. The collection of the images of Goddess Parvati are preserved in various museums. Sculpture Shed Riva, Hari Singh God Museum Sagar, Sirpur, Sahdol, Neeraj Jain Collection, Satna, Ashapuri, Gandharvapuri, Indore, Ujjain, Jabalpur, Maheshwara, etc. In a large number of different periods like the Pratiharas, Kalachuri, Chandela, Pramara, and Kachyaghata, etc. All these images of Parvati have a certain peculiar features which are not found in other groups. The figures of Parvati consists of four arms carrying usual attributes. In most of the Kushana period, the images are shown performing Pancha Agni Tapana. The medieval sculptures of Parvati represent the conformity of the textual description. Most of the images of the post-Gupta period are Sathanaka or Asana Murtis. Sathanaka Murti on a pedestal or on a godha are quite popular. Asana Murti of Parvati on a pedestal, throne, lotus, Nandi and Shivalinga are found in various museums. Some remarkable images of Parvati are worth mentioning here. A few statues in the Mathura Museum show four-armed Parvati holding conch with two hands in front of her breast. The other hands hold a sword and a Nagapasha. On the right side, a miniature Linga and on the left, Ganesha are depicted. Another interesting image of Parvati shows the goddess standing in Tribhanga pose and playing on Veena. On her left, a Shivalinga is stalled on a pedestal. V.S. Agarwal remarks that she is represented here in her Vaishnavi aspect and a small Garuda is shown standing on the right side in Anjali Mudra. large number of images of Parvati from Hingalekar are acquired in the collection of Indo Central Museum. These are remarkable for the study of Parvati in the form of Panchatapas. There are several types of this aspect of the goddess in the collection of various museums of Madhya Pradesh with minor variations. The plaque representing the figures of Parvati in a standing pose are comparatively very few, but two pieces are recovered from Sirpur from Swastika Monastery during excavations. Goddess Parvati displayed in a standing pose on a platform carved in relief on a stone slab. Apart from such images, the bronze image of Parvati of Gomiti and Hirapur are unique. The deities are four-handed and usual ornaments are attractive. Apart from the above mentioned images of Parvati, many more can be seen in the museums of universities and private collections. Thank you very much. Thanks.